Okay, so welcome back. This is the last exercise for this basic introduction to motion graphics and After Effects. For doing this exercise, you are going to need to work with this video that I've uploaded previously. It's an interview to a fictional character from video games. Might know him. Yeah, it's Super Mario Bros. Super Mario, one of the brothers, I mean. So I'm going to import that, have it on the desktop. When importing that, you see that sometimes, depending on your settings, it would create automatically a composition based on those parameters. Okay, if you have the composition, that's perfectly fine. If you want to nest it in another composition, remember you just would need to select that and pre-compose. In case you want to segment all the materials of your composition in different nested compositions. I'm going to segment just a small piece of this interview. These are like 10 seconds. I'm gonna click here twice on the layer, and I'm going just to segment this. And that way, when I come back, this is the part I segmented. Well, if you want to work more comfortable, you might probably want to get rid of all this and through composition settings, modifying to 15 seconds or 10 seconds. But the other way you can do as well is just go to the end of your work area, and then you have here an option, which is trim composition to work area. And that way, you have already adjusted the duration of the composition to the material you have. This exercise is for you to understand selections, which in the context of motion graphics are transformed into masks. We have already worked with masks, if you think about that, when we introduced the alpha channels. This is the same principle. So imagine, for example, I want to create the effect of this character being anonymous, being protected, you know, like a whiteness protection program or something like that. You would like this character not to be recognized, okay? So in order to do that, it would be easy if we create a mask, okay, surrounding the character, like with the face shape. And then later, we apply an effect. In order to do that, first of all, I'm going to segment this this conversation in three shots, the three shots we have previously defined. And the first thing you're gonna notice is that After Effects is not the best program to do these cuts. You are probably working more comfortable if you just go to Premiere or to any other editing software in order to prepare these materials and work with independent cuts. Okay, saying that, what you can do always is just create different layers here. Okay, and this one is going to be the first shot. Second shot is going to be this one. And then the third shot is going to be around you create a mask selecting the layer and then selecting this tool. You can create a mask to your own taste, like for example this one here, just drag it, okay, and then yeah, try to not to do something too messy, okay, and then this way, and then this way, and then this way, okay. Alternatively, you can also use this other just to create an sphere, which is perfectly fine, but I'm going to do it with this personalized one. It doesn't matter. Okay, So what you do with this is just a cut mask. You are cutting all the material and just leaving this part. A mask, as you remember from the lesson, can work in different sense. You could even have no one, okay? You can subtract, but in this case, I want to add. I want just to keep the face. And you would say, well, we need both of them, yes. What we are going to do is duplicate this layer, and in the second layer, we are going to get rid of the mask. So that way, you don't see any difference, but, and this is where the magic begins, we are going to apply an effect only to the first mask, the first layer that has a mask. So for example, this one, the mosaic, and that would be, I mean, I'm going to create more, All the effects that you apply within this layer would be always apply inside the limits of that mask. That mask, or as many masks as you want. So for example, you could perfectly create two different masks here. And this one you want to subtract, so that way, it is still more or less clear who is the character. Okay. In this particular case, we can see the character.
The game French.
By the way, if you want to disable the sound, okay. Yes, mute this. In this particular case, the character doesn't really move that much, and that's why the mask works. But what happens if the character is moving like this guy, like the presenter? In that case, you will need to animate the positions of each of the anchors within the mask. Okay. In order to do that, you will need to select the mask. It's this one, the mask one. And in the mask path, activating the stopwatch here, you will need to move this, okay, depending on the position. So if here it moves a little, you should adjust that, and here you should adjust that. Okay, so again, that would depend on what you want to do. If instead of applying a mosaic effect, we apply something more subtle or more artistic, you might need to use the feather to smooth the transition of the limits of the mask, this property here. Let's see. So for example, if you apply the color balance here to this one, you can increase a little the saturation, okay, and again you would see here the limits with the feather. So now is the moment where you can play a little using the different effects, applying always here or in different masks or in different layers.